Welcome in. I'm Sam Monson. He is Zach Robinson. And today we're going to talk about the New York Jets training camp, heading into camp. Zach, three things to watch for the Jets. I think the first one is, which one of these dozens and dozens of receivers is actually going to end up sticking on this roster and making some noise? They were up to 16 at one point recently. Now they're down to 12. But that's still, what, half over what they need to end up with?
Yeah, it's just Robbie Anderson and a bunch of guys. Terrell Pryor, Jermaine Kearse, Andre Roberts, Quincy Enunwa. Who's going to separate from the pack? Terrell Pryor, we've seen some good from him. Kearse, Andre Roberts are adequate players in the NFL, but a ton of targets are going to go to Robbie Anderson this season. We'll see who can shake out of that.
And even Robbie Anderson is a very specific type of receiver. He is one of the premier deep threats in today's NFL. Last season, 7 touchdowns on deep targets, so 20-plus yards in the air, down the field. He's as good as anybody, but they need somebody, whether it's Terrell Pryor, whether it's Jermaine Kearse coming in, Quincy Enunwa, somebody needs to step up and be that reliable possession, move the chains kind of guy to complement Robbie Anderson.
Yeah, I'm still trying to figure out who that guy is. Andre Roberts has had some good moments in his career. I think out of that group that you just mentioned, Jermaine Kearse might end up being that guy, kind of consistency day in and day out, but it's going to be interesting to see how this thing shakes out.
And I had such high hopes for Terrell Pryor after that first year as a receiver with the Browns. Really took a step back last year, and I don't know if he's going to be that guy, but he's got the talent, I think, to do it. The next story is obviously the quarterback situation there. In particular, the one guy I want to focus on, Teddy Bridgewater. This is a guy who has a chance to be a great return story in today's NFL, a guy who had back-to-back seasons in the 80s for the Vikings to start his career, and then just a catastrophic freak knee injury almost cost him his leg, let alone his NFL career. He ends up signing with the Jets, and there's a real path there to doing something, to playing time.
Absolutely. If he can just stay healthy and show that he can get back to having confidence in that knee again, Teddy Bridgewater is a great quarterback in the NFL. He can be definitely a top half guy if he can get back into there. You look at just what they've got, the pieces around him, it's not great to feel confident in standing in there, but he's a guy that's got a ton of talent, great processor, can work through progressions and simply just find the open man. So definitely going to be interested to see how Teddy Bridgewater plays this training camp.
And I think he gets liberated a bit more by getting outside of the confines of North Turner's offense, which held him back, I think, a little bit in Minnesota, forced him into being this check down kind of receiver that he took a lot of criticism for. The big concern, though, you mentioned, though, is that offensive line, which isn't exactly helping out any of the quarterbacks that end up starting in New York. Kelvin Beachum at left tackle, James Carpenter left guard, Spencer Long at center. They did at least upgrade there marginally over Wesley Johnson. Right guard Brian Winters, who got signed to a big extension this offseason despite no real play backing up that level of investment in him. And then Brandon Shell at right tackle, whoever is behind that unit, that's looking like one of the worst offensive lines in the league on paper heading into camp.
Yeah, it's tough. And you look at Josh McCown, he was able to make some plays behind an offensive line and really to Robbie Anderson throwing go balls and deep balls. That's how this offense survived last season. So can they get a little bit more consistent just down to down and not rely on those big plays down the field that they had Josh McCown last season? It's definitely going to be something to watch.
And then the third thing to focus on, I think, heading into camp is this new look New York Jets secondary. Obviously, they made the investment last season with the two safeties at the top of the draft, but they've added in free agents. They've added in some more cornerback help in the draft as well. You've got Tremaine Johnson, Big Sky, coming over from the Los Angeles Rams. Maurice Claiborne is still there. Darrell Roberts, Justin Burns, and Parry Nickerson in the draft as well. This is now an intriguing group of corners to go with those safeties.
Yeah, absolutely. You look at Parry Nickerson, a guy that we liked in the NFL in the draft. Passer rating of just 39 when he was targeted last season at Tulane. Really athletic guy, ran a 4.3 at the combine. So you can see the athletic profile that fits. If he can get in there and make some plays in camp, he could be one of those guys locked down spot, because Maurice Claiborne, Darrell Roberts, those guys have had the ups and downs throughout the NFL, so that's definitely going to be something to look forward to.
Yeah, wasn't just a big-time playmaker in college, but he can fly 4.3 flat. That's a little bit better than Mike Renner managed in his time 40 recently.
That's a little too soon there, yeah.
Not for us. We can rub it in. It's Mike Renner's a little bit too soon for. But I think the position battle to watch, it's got to be that quarterback battle royale between Teddy Bridgewater, as you mentioned, rookie Sam Darnold, and the incumbent there, that's Josh, help me out. Who's his
Josh McCown.
Josh McCown.
Yeah.
There you go.
Josh, yeah, that's it's going to be interesting. I sure wouldn't feel good about putting Sam Darnold, even if he shows that he's ready to go. You look at this roster offensively, we've mentioned the offensive line, the receivers that are trying to battle out for a spot. I wouldn't feel good about putting Sam Darnold, even if he shows a lot in training camp. So then you're looking at Teddy Bridgewater, Josh McCown. I'd love to see Teddy Bridgewater come out of there and prove that he can get back to that level of play. So out of those two guys, Josh McCown's had his ups, his downs, played in the NFL a long time. But if Teddy Bridgewater could come out of that, I think it would be a lot of fun to see.
And I think if that's a fair competition between those two veterans, I would lean on Teddy Bridgewater as being the guy that would come out of that. Last season was really, I think, a career year out of McCown, an unexpectedly good performance from him. But what was really interesting is when we started to run those clutch quarterback numbers, you know, late in the fourth quarter, a few minutes left, score within seven. Josh McCown is one of the worst quarterbacks in the PFF era in those situations. So if you can upgrade to a guy like Bridgewater who can still get it done in crunch time, that's got to be an upgrade worth making.
Absolutely. And I think he's just got a uniqueness about his game that we mentioned. He's a great processor, accurate thrower. If he shows confidence in that knee, he's going to be in good shape.
So that's going to do it for our roundup of the New York Jets heading into training camp. Hit the like button, hit subscribe, and check out the rest of the PFF channel for all 32 teams.